retirement. It can either be a day you are really looking forward to as your Independence Day, the day I will be free, I'll do whatever I want and I'll be on my own. Or it can be a day of mourning. I will lose my identity, I will not have a job, I will not have a designation. Now that your retirement is coming close, the choice is yours. Are you going to celebrate your retirement or are you going to mourn your retirement? Everything depends on your attitude towards life, firstly, and secondly, your attitude towards your job. Never forget that your job, your designation, your skill, your vocation was only an instrument in your life. If somewhere you have made it part of your identity, then you are going to be in trouble. If you say, I am much more than my job and my designation and my salary, then you are going to really enjoy yourself. This is the first time in your life you will not have a boss, you will not have restrictions, you will not have the pressure that I have to get up in the morning and go to office and reach there at such and such time. You will not have targets, you will not have anything. So, is that going to make you happy? Or is it going to leave you sad saying, I have nothing to do? If it is the second one, the fault is yours. It is you who have not planned. Most people, when they come to retirement, they plan out their finances. If I'm not going to have so much salary, how am I going to manage? Have I invested money? Am I getting some monthly returns? Most of us take care of our housing. Where am I going to live? I need a safe place. I may not be able to pay rent, etc. Most of us take care of our health schemes. You know, I should have health insurance. I should have a good doctor. I should have those type of things. We take care of our children. Are they well settled? And are they able to live independently? And things of that sort. But the one area in which many of us fail to take any preemptive steps is our emotional well-being. Am I emotionally going to be at peace within myself and harmony with others? Am I going to be a contented and a peaceful and a happy person? Please remember, the way longevity and healthcare is going, if you have spent 30-35 years as a working person, you can look forward to 30-35 years post-retirement. That is the way longevity is increasing. Healthcare is improving. Your physical health may be perfect. 30 years from now, you may be still fit and fine to walk a long distance, drive a car, do whatever you want. But mentally, how are you? If you are going to be living in the past, if you are going to be thinking only of the good old days, if you are going to feel miserable with the way your identity has been lost, nobody can help you. And that becomes a vicious cycle into which people start going deeper and deeper and deeper. They go into depression, they isolate themselves from society and from their family members, and eventually they die very lonely and very miserable people. On the other hand, if you say, I am not going to impose myself on my family, I am not going to expect others to look after me, I am going to make my own social circle, I am going to find activities which I love to do, including a lot of activities which I had to give up because I had a full-time job. I am going to build my own hobbies, creativity. I am going to look into spirituality, whatever it may be. If you start planning and do it by trial and error, you will not succeed in everything. Something will work out, something will not work out. But keep doing. There's no hurry, there's no target, there's no restriction on you. Enjoy every aspect of your retired life. It is going to be the most wonderful years of your life if you plan yourself in your mind to ensure your own well-being and to ensure a good, balanced life. Happy retirement.